Do you know how to apply validation on form field in Power Pages site? Hi, this is Priyanka Kumari from Noho Academy. So first let me take one real life scenario. Suppose there is a job application form and in this form it is required a phone number validation. So there is a users, or we can say applicants, are filling out an online job application for a company, and the form collects various details, include personal information, work experience, contact details such as phone number. So in this field phone number, there is a validation rules that may include checking for the correct number of digits allowing only numeric characters, and it also validating phone numbers helping the company maintain efficient communication with applicants, and also it also enhance the overall user experience by guiding applicants to provide accurate contact information. So let me tell you that how you can give the validation of these fields like name, phone number and email address. And here you can see that I can already create one form, that is Comedian registration form. And if you want to give a validation to a form, so there are two ways to give the validation. That first way, that you can give a validation to the website, and the another way that you can give a validation in a portal management app. So first I have to tell you that how you can give a validation in the website directly using a regular expression. So let me tell you that how you can give a validation from a website on directly. So we have to select first field, that is name, and we go edit field, and after that here you can see there is an edit text field and their field label, that is name. Use a custom error message here you can give also. So there is a validation section for, I can go regular expression. Let me code my regular expression code for from my notepad. So I can go here and let me select this, that is Ctrl plus C, and after that we have to go this edit field regular function, and we have to copy this. And basically this anchor tag means that is the starting of the string, and this the small alphabets and capital alphabets can be include the lowercase and uppercase letters, and slash s means that is a white space it represent, and there is a dollar sign means it is the ending of the string. So let me click on done, and we have to preview this also. So let me enter first name like this, and we click on submit, and let's see it accept the data or not. So here you can see there is a message that name is not valid. So first we have to delete. Let me enter my name like Shakshi, and we click on submit. So here you can see there is an error message will be disappear. So now we have to enter a number, there is an email address, and we click on submit. So here you can see our submission completed successfully.
So next we have to take another field, that is phone number. So I click on edit field, and here you can see there is a field label, that is phone number, and make this field required also. And you can enter a custom message also. For now I can take the validation. So there is a two ways, that is simple and regex. If I can select this, so here you can enter that the phone number did not exceed the 10 digits. So let me click on done also, and we have to preview after this. Let me enter the name, and let me enter our digits, like our random digits, and I click on submit. So here you can see that our text exceed the maximum character count, that is 10. So let me delete this, and let me enter the number, there is a random number, and let me click on submit. So here you can see that the phone number can be entered successfully and the digit can be only 10. So let me tell you that how you can validate a phone number. So there is another way also validate a phone number using regular function. So I can select this field, and I can go edit field, and let me choose this regex, and let me enter a regular expression of phone number. So I can copy this first, Ctrl plus C, and after that I can paste this here. So let me explain this. This anchor tag first describes the starting of the string, and this dollar sign describes the ending of the string. And there is a 6 to 9, it specified that the phone number can be start to 6 to 9 range, and $/T specified that digit can be in a singular digit. And let me click on done after, and that we have to preview this also. So let me enter one number like this can be like this, and I can click on this is name and click on submit. It's can't exceed the strength length, so it can be. So here you can see a form can be submitted with the validation. So let me show you that you show error also. So let me demonstrate you that how you can validate the email address in Power Pages platform. So let me select this field also, and we go on edit field. Here you can see there is an added email field. In this field there is a field label that is email address. For now make this field required, and here you can enter a custom error message also. And in the validation there is a two option, that is simple and regex. For now we on this toggle, and there is a restrict email addresses by domain. In this there is a two option, that is only allow email addresses from specific domains and don't allow email addresses from specific domains. So let me enter one domain, that is @gmail.com. so it's only accept this specific domain. So we click on done also, and let me preview this. So let me enter our email address first, that is priyanka@gmail.in, and let me click on submit. So here you can see there is an error, that is that email domain is not allowed. So for now I can change this, and it can be .com, and we click on submit. So here you can see the error of email address can be disappeared. For now I can enter my name, and let me enter my phone number, and I click on submit. So here you can say submission completed successfully. So after that there is another way of validate the email address. So I have to select the field. So we go edit field, and we choose the regex option, and let me select the regular expiration from my notepad. So we go this, and let me select this Ctrl+C. After that let me select this again also, edit field, regex function, and let me copy this. And here you can see that this is the starting of the email address. This is specified, it includes the lowercase, uppercase, and numbers. And of the @ there also include the lowercase, uppercase, and numbers. And after dot there is only specify the smaller and lowercase. And this too specify that it only includes the .com, .in domains, and the $ specified the ending of the string. And let me click on done, and let me preview this also. So let me enter an email address, and I click on submit. So it not show any errors. So for now if I can delete this .com, and let me click on submit. So here you can see that email address is not valid. So for now I can enter a .com, and let me enter my name also, and let me enter my phone number also, and we click on submit. So here you can see that email address can be successfully submitted in the form. So there is another way to validate these fields. So we go edit form, and we go data, and we can open portal management app. Here you can see there is a feature that is advanced configuration are available in the portal management app. Basically portal management app to provide a model driven power app for advanced configuration of your Power Pages site. And if your website is using the enhanced data model, so you can use Power Pages management. Like you can give the validation of the fields, so you have to open portal management. So we can open this, and here you can see there is a table name and there is a form name. So we go from basic form metadata, and basically basic form metadata to enhance the features to store additional information about their forms. And let me create a new basic form metadata, and let me select the attribute. basically attribute represent the columns of the database, and there is a logical name of the, so here you can see there is a logical name, that is CRBA3_H. So for now I can select the email address, and let me go and let me, here you can see there is a validation section, and let me copy a regular expression code. So we go notepad, so I can copy this first, Ctrl+C, and after that I can paste here, just Ctrl+V, and let field is be required, and let me save these changes in the new basic form metadata. So we can click on save, and we have to save and close also, and this can also be saved, and we have to save and close also, and we have to save this and save and close also. After that I can click on OK, sync this and preview also. After that, let me show you demo that this feature can be applied or not. So we have to enter our one email address, like sakshi@gmail.com. For now I cannot enter .com, and let me show you, if you click on submit button, that what happened. So I click on this, and here you can see that email address is not valid, it can be shown. So let me enter our .com, and after we click on submit button, here you can see email address here, the error can be removed. So let me enter a name also, and we can enter a Sakshi, and we click on submit. So here you can see our form can be submitted successfully, and we have to give this type of validation in Open Portal Management app also. So let me show you another validation, like field email address. So again we go edit form and data, we open portal management app, and after that we go basic form metadata, and let me create a new basic metadata for a new validation. So we go and let me choose a attribute, and let me choose the column name. So for now we choose the phone number. So after that I can enter a regular expression here. So we have to copy this, so we go notepad, and let me select this, Ctrl+C, and after I have to paste this here, and this field also can be a required, and we click on save and save and close. So here you can see a new basic metadata can be created for phone number also. So we go here, we click on OK, we sync this and preview also. So let me show you that this validation can be work or not. So I can enter our random number for now. So we click on submit. It shows that phone number is not valid because this exceeds the 10 digit also. For now I can delete this. Let me count this, 1, 2, 3. We click on submit. So here you can see that phone number is can be work validation. So after that we can enter this email address, and we click on submit. So here you can see that form can be submitted successfully with the validation of phone number and email address both. So I hope you can understand the validation of portal management app. So there is another question arise, that what is the difference between that you can give a validation from a directly website also, and you can give a validation from portal management also. In this I can use a form. In form you can give a validation directly of the field in the directly website also, but if you use the list, and you can create a form, and from creating a form you can insert the data, and in that form you need a validation, so you can use a portal management app. So this is the major difference, that you can give a validation, so you can know the validation two ways, that you can specify both based on requirements, so you can give a validation in both forms also. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you navigate the tech world. If you have any question, don't hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. So stay curious and keep learning.